In this video, we will be installing the clutch disc and pressure plate assemblies on a 1943 Willys MB. Let's take a look at the flywheel on the back of the L134 engine here. The flywheel has been remachined and balanced at Jimmy Strauss Jeeps, and all I've really done is just wipe it down with a little acetone to get any oily residue off the top. I'm using a brand new clutch disc assembly from Ron Fitzpatrick Jeep Parts. The part number is 636755. I'll take the clutch disc assembly out of the packaging, and you'll note here on the one side it says flywheel side. So you're going to want to orient this clutch disc, that side's going to face or touch the flywheel. It's very important to make sure the clutch disc assembly is oriented correctly towards the flywheel. I'll be using an installation tool, part number 930733. You simply insert it through the splines, and then the point of the tool is inserted into the bushing in the flywheel. It'll hold the disc in place when we install the pressure plate. I'm using new bolts and lock washers, and they come as a bolt kit, part number 630129. I'll be installing a Ron Fitzpatrick Jeep Parts new pressure plate. There is no adjustment needed here. This comes adjusted from the factory. All I've done again is I've just wiped off this surface with some acetone to make sure it's clean. The pressure plate assembly is part number 638992, and all you have to do is align the holes on the pressure plate with the threaded holes on the flywheel. Once you locate your pressure plate in a proper area, install a lock washer and a bolt in each one of the holes. Install all six bolts and lock washers and just tighten them down finger tight for the time being. Double check that your pressure plate is in line with the clutch disc plate assembly and tighten the bolts with a ratchet and socket. I like to tighten the fasteners in a crisscross pattern just so I know that I'm pulling the pressure plate down evenly and I won't get any binding or movement. After I get all the bolts snugged with the ratchet and socket, I'll go back in with a torque wrench, and as per manual specs, I will torque them between 12 and 17 pounds. So I'm just going to shoot right in the middle and go for 15. Once again, I like to go in a crisscross pattern when I'm torquing the bolts. You may have to hold the flywheel so the engine doesn't turn at this point. After I've got all the bolts torqued, I'll go around the outside perimeter of the flywheel and just double check that I've got them all at 15 pounds. Then I'll remove the installation tool. Your clutch disc and pressure plate are now installed.